Welcome to another SkyMind video tutorial. In this screencast, I'm going to demonstrate adding a neural net to the DataVec image pipeline example. So in the DataVec image pipeline example, we wrote a directory of images and applied labels to them. In this example, I'm going to take that previous example and add a multi-layer network to it. I'm going to train the model against our training data set. And then we're going to test the model with the test data set. This example will be added to our examples repo. It's available in this location, and the instructions for downloading that are available at the second URL. Thank you. In a previous example, I built a image data pipeline that processes a collection of files of images stored in directories where the directory name is the label of the image. And that example is here, and it's detailed in another video. Now I'm going to take the next natural step. I'm going to add a neural net to that example. So I'm working in IntelliJ. I recommend you do the same. I am going to copy the class that we had previously. And I'm just going to call this add neural net. What do we need to do if I'm converting this to a real working example with a neural net? The first thing, this batch size of 1 was there for demonstration purposes only. So let's go ahead and set that to 128. When we process our data, we want to specify the number of epochs, the number of total passes through the data set. And I'm going to set that to 15. Down here, we no longer need this little loop that just shows us the format of the data. I think we're ready to start adding our neural net. As I work through this example, it might be useful to switch into presentation mode. So let's go ahead and build our model. Let's output some log information. And how do we go about building our model? There it is, multi-layer configuration. I'm going to call that conf, and that's a neural net configuration builder is what we need. In addition to setting the random seed to a particular value so that we get reproducible results, we can also specify the optimization algorithm. And we're going to use stochastic gradient descent. Specify the number of iterations as 1. Specify a learning rate. I'm going to specify the learning rate as 0.006. We specify an updater, a momentum, regularization set to true, now we can start adding a layer. First layer, layer 0. We're going to use dense layer builder for this. As our input, we specify the height and the width of the images. Our number out, this specifies the number of neurons in our next layer. Let's set this to 100. Specify our activation algorithm. Specify the initial weight. And build. Now that we're done with our first layer, we can add our second layer. And this is going to be our output layer. Specify the loss function. specify the number in. The number in is going to have to match the number out from the previous. The number out, and that'll be 10, right? Because we have 10 digits that we're classifying in this example. Specify our activation function. Specify an initial weight. And build. Now that we've configured our network and we've added our two layers, let's do pre-train as false and backprop is true. We need to set the input type, and our record reader is going to feed us an input type we can call convolutional, and we specify the height, width, and the depth. Actually, height, width, and channels for the size of our images and the layers of the images. So 28, and a single layer because it's grayscale. And then build. And that's it for our network. After we've built our model, let's go ahead and use it. Let's set a listener so we can get output to see if it's training. And let's listen every 10 updates. Then let's go ahead and train the model. So a for loop for the number of epochs. And then in this for loop, we want to call fit using our data iter. And that should be it. Let's go ahead and see if that runs. A few things before we run this example. You absolutely want to make sure that you comment out this log record listener. That's going to write one line of output for every image that's read, 60,000 lines of output. I also had a typo here. I had height, comma, width. It's height times width. And now I should be able to run this example. As we see while the model runs, the output training number, it is training. So it's getting smaller in terms of its recommendations. So we do have a somewhat successful network here. Now that we have a model that is training, that seems like it's going to work for our data set, we need to evaluate that model. So what do we need to evaluate our model? Well, we need to take our test data and compare it to the output of the neural net. So to step through our test data, we're going to reset our record reader. And then we need to read the test data. And the input split we labeled as test up above. And here's the code that we're taking a look at. Remember, in the beginning we specified a file split for the train data and a file split for the test data. And we're going to use the record reader that we used against the training data. We're now going to use it against the test data, and we're going to pass those data sets through to the network to validate. So we're specifying, use the record reader we defined earlier, use the batch size that we defined earlier, specify where the offset for the label is, and the total number of labels. We scaled the images that we sent to be trained, so we need to scale these images as well. Let's start by creating an evaluation object with 10 possible classes. And then let's loop through the test iterator. While we're looping through the test iterator, you'll recognize some of this code from the first example where I displayed the contents of the iterator as a data set. So we want the data set from next. While in this loop, we want to compare the model's output, the model's prediction to the label for the data set based upon the directory that it was in. And we do that like this. So we passed our data set next through to the model and get the feature matrix output from that. And then we compare the two. Let's log the statistics of that evaluation. Now that we've built our model, we've run it briefly to verify that it was training. Then we've added some evaluation code to check our test data against our training data, against our trained network's output. Let's go ahead and run this. This is going to take some time to run, so I'm going to stop the recording and then I'll just show you the final evaluation output. Once our model completes the fitting for 15 epochs and then runs the test data through, we can take a look at the statistics. So it looks like label 0 was labeled as 0 1,000 times, and there were a few times that it was misclassified. And the same goes for most of them, right? Over 90% accuracy. What do we have a little trouble with? Our 1 being labeled as a 2. Some of that makes a little bit of sense. So there's our output. So fairly accurate, trained fairly quickly. So it's not so good with 9s. So there you have it. In our next video in this series, we will store the trained model, load the trained model, and then evaluate new images.